TCP is connection oriented protocol, so it establishes the virtual path between the source and destination. Here TCP uses the services of IP, which is connection less protocol, to deliver the individual segment to the destination, but TCP controls the connection itself and takes care of lost or corrupted packets and retransmit it. TCP transmits data in full duplex mode. When two TCPs in two machines are connected, they are able to send segments to each other simultaneously. This implies that each party must initialize communication and get approval from the other party before any data is transferred, called three-way handshaking. So let's understand it. The connection establishment in TCP is called three-way handshaking. Here, the client wants to make a connection with another application program called the server. The server program tells its TCP that it is ready to accept a connection. This request is called a passive open. So when a client program issues a request for an active open, a client that wishes to connect to an open server tells its TCP to connect to a particular server. TCP can now start the three-way handshaking process. First, the client sends the first segment, that's SYN segment, in which only the SYN flag is set. This segment is for synchronization of sequence numbers. The client takes a random number called initial sequence number, ISN, and suppose it is 6000. SYN segment is a control segment and carries no data. However, it consumes one sequence number. When the data transfer starts, the initial sequence number is incremented by one. We can say that the SYN segment carries no real data, but we can think of it as containing one imaginary byte. Now the server sends the second segment called SYN plus ACK segment with two flag bits set, that is SYN and ACK. This segment has a dual purpose. First, it is a SYN segment for communication in the other direction. The server uses this segment to initialize a sequence number like 13,000 for numbering the bytes sent from the server to the client. The server also acknowledges the receipt of the SYN segment from the client by setting the ACK flag and displaying the next sequence number like 6001, which the server expects to receive from the client. Because it contains an acknowledgement, it also needs to define the receive window size like 5000 for flow control. At last, the client sends the third segment. This is an ACK segment. It acknowledges the receipt of the second segment with the ACK flag and acknowledgement number 13001. Here also the sequence number in this segment is the same in the SYN segment, 6000. The ACK segment does not consume any sequence number. The client must also define the server window size. Suppose it is 8000. In general, the third segment usually does not carry data and consumes no sequence numbers. Now we will see how TCP is doing three-way handshaking. Here we will start capturing the packets and we will visit any website like wikipedia.org. So here you can see several TCP packets has been captured by Wireshark. So we will stop the capturing now and we will search TCP packets. Then here you can see you have this sequence of packet in which first is the scene packet, then you have a scene plus ACK packet, and then you have a ACK packet. So this is what the three-way handshaking. So here when you open the synchronization packet, you will get the sequence number, that is 83 here, and you have an acknowledgement number, that is 0 here, and you can see the synchronization bit is 1 here, and you have a source port number, that is ephemeral port number like 57,680, and destination port number is 443 here. Now the next packet is coming from source port 443 to the client ephemeral port, that is 57,680, and here you can see there is an initial sequence number set by the server, and we have a acknowledgement number, that is one more than that we have seen in the scene packet. Since it is ACK plus scene packet, your acknowledgement bit is set 1 and synchronization bit is also set 1, and it is also giving the window size, that is 42,340. Now after getting scene plus ACK packet, client will send the acknowledgement with the client port number to the server port number. And here you have a sequence number that is one more than the previous one because it carries some data. If it is not carrying any data, it is normally same to the scene packet. And you can see your acknowledgement number here with acknowledgement bit is set to 1. And client is also advertising its window size. So this is what the three-way handshaking for the connection establishment. Now after connection is established, client and server can transfer the data in both directions. That we will see in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.
If you like this video, press like and subscribe the channel and share the video. And don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.